Hello guys, welcome back to another episode of Manga and Anime Weekly Updates on Our Eyes, Your Eyes. Before starting, I remind you, as always, to subscribe to the channel, click on the notification bell, and share this video with all the people who want weekly updates regarding manga and anime. It's time to jump right into the video, because today I have a lot of things to tell you, so let's start. Do you remember the Comiket, this great fair that it's happening every year, two times per year, here in Tokyo? As you all know, this year it was a problem for all of us, and the Comiket decided to postpone the fair of August and December to next year, 2021, precisely during the Golden Week. So we have to wait at the beginning of May 2021 in order to attend the fair. Let's remember that the Comiket is famous worldwide, so let's hope that next year everything will be okay and things will go on in the best way. Next update. Now I want to talk to you about theme parks. You need to know that the movie of Doraemon that has to come in August, I mean really really soon here in Japan, is already successful. In fact, in USJ, Universal Studio Japan, they are preparing an attraction dedicated to this movie. So if you have the chance to be here in Japan during this period and you wanted to have fun always following the security measures, of course, go and enjoy in Osaka, the Universal Studio Japan, and this attraction regarding Doraemon. I put here the picture next to me, so you, here or here, I don't know, so you will understand what I'm talking about. Do you like Doraemon? Do you like the next movie of Doraemon that is coming? Let's say that it's a remake of one of his first movies. But anyway, do you like Doraemon in general? Let me know in the comments. Next update. We are talking about right now an update. It's not regarding manga and anime. Sorry, I wanted to say it anyway. It's about Hello Kitty. For all the fans of Hello Kitty who are living in Japan or who are in Japan right now for other reasons, you need to know that in Narita Airport, there is an area dedicated to Hello Kitty. Specifically speaking, I'm talking about a Hello Kitty cafe. Look, it's a limited stuff. It means that it's not going to last so long. I think it's a little bit pointless in this period of time, because we can't take airplanes, we can't travel, we can't do anything. So I don't know how many people will reach Narita Airport right now, and I don't know how many months or weeks is lasting this project. But anyway, if it happens to you that you're in Narita Airport for some reasons, go and check out this cafe. Eat something and tell me if it was oishii or oishikunai. You know that a great life-size Gundam was built in China. You asked yourself probably, what's the reason why? Here in Japan we have an Odaiba Gundam. They changed it after so many years recently. I think 1 year ago, yes. Last year in October I think they changed it, yeah. But right now in China they are projecting to build a big, huge shopping center, a mall, and it's about to open in 2021, and this life-size Gundam will be there as well. So they will use it as a debut of this great mall. I'm talking about the Shanghai area, so if you go to Shanghai, Shanghai as we say in Italy, and you have the chance to go to this big mall opening, take a picture of your big, huge Gundam and put it in the comments below. Here in Japan, there is a special magazine called Manga Goraku. You need to know that from this week, they announced that this type of magazine will be digitally available only. So you will never be able to buy it in bookstores and manga stores. Probably the reason why is that now everything is turning digital. So they wanted to update themselves in order to find a way to become digital. Have you ever read this magazine? Leave me a comment below. I've never heard of it, also because I am an anime only, so I don't know anything about that. But look, if you know this magazine, leave me a comment below and tell me your opinions. Okay, so right now, as always, we start the section called New Anime Coming! Exactly, because in this week there were announced lots lots of new anime coming, especially we also know the dates in some cases. So right now I'm going to read you this list that I prepared and tell me your feelings about them. The second cool, that means the second half of the fourth season of Haikyuu, it's coming in October. And I wanted to tell you another thing that is coming in October regarding Haikyuu, that is the live stage called Dumpster Battle. If you have the chance to come to Japan in October, or if you're here in Japan already in that period, go and check out this live stage. I think it could be nice to see a live stage dedicated to volleyball. Go and check out other updates online to know the days, the tickets, and whatever. Next, I'm going to talk to you about the second season of Baia no Studio, made by Kyoto Animation. It's coming, this new anime, on the 23rd of July. And I have to tell you another thing. In this week, there was the first anniversary of the Kyoto Animation fire. So I wanted to send a positive message to KyoAni, who are really, really great, who can create great masterpieces. So go ahead, KyoAni, you will make it. Another anime that is coming, it's called The Black Channel, and the first episode will start the 21st of August. This story is strange because we find a YouTuber, a demon YouTuber, that has to get in touch with humans, I mean with human beings. That could be really, really interesting to see this anime. Leave me a comment below and tell me your opinions about that. Another anime movie, in this case, that it's coming at the cinema is Kimi wa Kanata. And the starting date is the 27th of November. So if you have the chance to go to the cinema in this date and you love this story, remember that the movie is starting from the 27th of November. Another announcement of this week was the trailer of Jujutsu Kaisen, the new anime produced by MAPPA Studio that it's coming this October. It will be aired on NHK. I'm going to follow it. So if you want some reaction videos regarding Jujutsu Kaisen, I will be there. I'm maybe a little bit later than usual, but I will be there. Another anime that is starting in October, sorry, I have to read it for sure in this case because it's too long, the title. It's called Kimi to Boku no Saigo no Senjo, Arui wa Sekai ga Ajimaru Seisen. I don't know anything about this anime, but I saw that many people are recommending this. I don't know, leave me a comment below and tell me your opinions and thoughts, as always. Another anime that is starting in October. Look, this list, I can call it October list instead of a new anime coming, because everything is starting in October. Mojo de Oyasumi is starting in October. So if you like it or if you want to have a chance to watch it, remember October. Last announcement of this week regarding new anime coming is regarding Koya no Kotobuki Hikotai. It's coming in September, not in October. But of course, we are not talking about anime only, as I am. Okay. I'm talking about now the new manga projects coming that they were announced this week. Yuji Shiozaki, that was the author of Ikkitosen, and Daisuke Higuchi, that was the author of Whistle, they are both creating new mangas. Of course, one for Shiozaki and one for Higuchi. But we don't know any details about them, so stay tuned. They just announced that they are preparing a new manga, so new ideas. Another good thing is that if you love Kimi ni Todoke, the 11th of August, the 6th spin-off is coming out. Kimi ni Todoke is already a finished manga, but they decided to make some spin-off, and this is number 6. So check it out if you have the chance to read it. Another manga that is coming, it will be made by Keiko Nishi, and it will start the 14th of November. And the last but not least, Hiroshi Motomiya Sensei is starting a new manga called Boku Imasio, and it will start the 6th of August. These were the new manga coming, but now it's time to turn sad a little bit because we are talking about all the manga that are going to finish. The manga of Akira Hiramoto called Row Hero will end the 11th of August. The manga of Sanada Makoto, that it's called Satsuriku no Tenshi, he said that there are still 3 chapters left, so really, really soon the manga will finish. Another manga that is finishing is Crow Zero Reboot. In fact, the next chapter, it will be also the last one. Hippo, the manga, it's about about to finish the 27th of July, so really, really soon, almost next week. And last but not least, the manga of Shoten Akira called Arakure Night, Remember Tomorrow, will finish July the 28th. So right now, I wanted to finish this video with another section of these updates called Delays or Taking a Break, because you need to know that this year was really, really particular. And there were lots of delays, there were lots of movements of anime or manga, many, many delays regarding, you know what I mean. I don't have to tell you because you know what I mean. So right now I'm going to tell you a negative or a sad news regarding the My Hero Academia live stage that it was supposed to start at the end of July, that means right now. Unfortunately, two protagonists of the live stage, they resulted positive. You know what I mean. We don't know when it will come back, this live stage, but unfortunately it is what it is. I hope that all the characters are fine, and these two guys who were involved in, you know what I mean, I hope that you're safe right now and you can recover really, really soon. The manga Kuden no Himejimi, written by Kei Tome, will delay till October. More or less a 2 or 3 months delay in this case. We don't know the reasons, probably one of the reasons is you know what I mean. Another great name of a manga is Kingdom. The manga is about to delay till the 6th of August. Okay, it's really, really soon, but anyway, they decided to delay. Another great name is Yu-Gi-Oh! Also in this case, is delaying till the 8th of August. Another anime that was supposed to start in October, I mean in fall, that is Skate Leading Stars. Okay, they decided to delay everything and to move this anime to January 2021. Okay guys, so also these weekly updates regarding manga and anime for this week, that is it. Hope you enjoyed, even if it was a tiny, probably short video. I still don't know, I have to check it. But anyway, hope you enjoyed, and see you next week with other weekly updates here on Our Eyes Your Eyes. See you in the next video. Ah, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, click on the notification bell, and follow me. Bye bye.